So today we're checking out a pretty exciting earbuds from KZ, and the AS16 Pro is quite an awesome setup because, as its name suggests, this IEM comes with 16 total drivers to drive every frequency you can think of. And another good news is that they don't cost you an arm or a leg. Today's IEM was sent over to me by KZ for review, and although these were sent over to me, no money has exchanged hands, and this review will still be based on my honest and unbiased opinion. The AS16 Pro comes at a pretty competitive price at about $73, which is around 249 Malaysia ringgit, and if you really think about it, 250 ringgit for a good sounding earbuds isn't really too much to ask for. And in an audiophile world, I think these are really not expensive at all. So if you're interested in getting these IEMs, do check out my links in the description below. So these earbuds are pretty unique and actually has quite a similar design to the CCA Lyra that we checked out previously, and comes with a diamond-like resin design and closed with a metal front piece as well. So reason I don't quite fancy this design is because of the font, and I think they do add some character, but I'm not the biggest fan of this font. So behind this, you're gonna get a slightly contoured shape, not as edgy as the CCA Lyra that you can see here, which really angles really well and sits very nicely in my ears. And specifically for this earbuds, it doesn't really fit me all that well. This portion here of the earbuds do push themselves loose, and I have to like swap out different ear tips and they still do that. So just remember that fit is very subjective, and what fits me doesn't mean it will fit you. And inside this unit itself, compared to the CCA Lyra, you can see that this earbuds itself is jam-packed with drivers inside, because each of these earbuds comes with 8 total BA drivers inside. So there's literally no more space inside for anything else. And also, you can see this plastic piece inside that is actually a 3D printed sound guide that channels the 3 different frequencies separately into your ear guide. So it takes the low, mids and highs from different BA drivers and drive them individual tunnels through the ear guide. Pretty cool. So taking off the ear tips, you're gonna see a brass or copper color ear guide and that metal mesh in the front. Very nicely designed, but I'm not too sure whether this color matches up with the green body that well. But hey, at least you're getting a unique looking ear guides. So the cables you're gonna get here is the same cable that you're gonna get with the Lyra, and they are also interchangeable. You can either get it with the mic or without the mic, and I'll also show you how the mic sounds later on the test. So KZ gives you a high purity silver plated cable, so you don't get a mix of copper or silver wires here, to give you a best of the both worlds of warm and brightness of a mixed braided cable. But either way, a pretty basic cable here. And similar to the Lyra, you also get an L-shaped 3.5mm gold-plated jack. And if you get the one with the mic, you're gonna get the 3 lines here, which is a TRS connector or tip ring 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 sleeve, to give you stereo audio as well as a mic input. And without the mic, you're just gonna get a TRS connector. So the cable here also uses the standard 0.75mm gold-plated 2-pin connector. And similar to the Lyra, it's also recessed, so you just plug them into your IEMs directly. So the cool thing about the AS16 Pro is that it comes with 8 total drivers per side, and these are all balanced armature drivers. So that is how KZ can fit so many into a small enclosure. All of these balanced armature drivers are tuned differently to achieve that all-rounded frequency range. So 4 of those will manage the high frequencies, 2 will manage the mid-range, and another 2 will manage the lower frequencies. And the thing with BA drivers is that they do not excel in the low end. So as much as they tune the 2 drivers to deliver bass notes, they're still not that deep. The earbuds comes with a 23.5 ohm impedance, so it's actually lower powered compared to the Lyra at 28 ohms. But anyways, these are not very huge differences, and you can still run them with pretty much any player or even your phone. So at the end of the day, these are not very demanding IEMs to run. So sound quality on these are pretty good sounding. They are good, but not the best I've heard. But again, with all different BA drivers delivering accurate audio to your ears, I must say that this is still very impressive how they are built. The bass here is pretty good. Again, similar to the Lyra, they are very mid-bass focused and don't have enough depth to rumble the sub-bass. You're gonna get a pretty nice thumb for a BA driver setup, but comparing these to many dynamic drivers, they lose out quite a bit. But then again, IEMs are not meant to deliver insane bass notes, so what you're gonna get here is a pretty balanced output. The benefits of running so many different separate drivers is that they can be tuned to do very dedicated jobs, and with the mid-range and the vocals, these do an extremely well job. And you can hear the artist exactly next to your ears, so close that if you close your eyes, they sound like they are actually singing inside your ears. Really impressive there. Highs here is also okay, but despite having 4 separate BA drivers dedicated to the high notes, they don't feel like they are 100% bright, maybe somewhere around 80% I would say. Still pretty good, just not maximum brightness. And good thing is that they don't distort even at high volumes, and they don't crack, which is really nice. Again, another good execution from KZ. So this is a test to see if the mic that comes with the KZ AS16 Pro is a good microphone for making phone calls. So this is me speaking in a relatively quiet environment, and this is the call quality that you can expect. So what I'm going to do now is to turn on a simulated background noise so you can hear a difference. So now there's a simulated background noise playing in the background, and this is the call quality that you can expect from this microphone. So what do you think of the call quality? Let me know in the comment section down below. So I do think that this is a very nice execution from KZ, and although these are not as cheap as the CCA Lyra, they are still very competitively priced. If you don't need the better accuracy that these earbuds deliver, I would strongly urge that you check out the CCA Lyra, because those are quite a gem at $25 price tag. Definitely check those out. So that is it for this review. If you find this video helpful, smash that thumbs up button, share this video everywhere, and if you haven't yet subscribed, do consider subscribing. See you in the next video.